Hey YouTube, Koppersan here, and welcome to the unofficial Spring Blossoms content update guide. This update revamps the entire Zipangu area, reworking the quests, monsters and boss monsters for new and exciting challenges. The Haste Plus event is back as well, making grinding even easier and more rewarding. Let's take a closer look, shall we? The questline for the Heisen Temple has been simplified. You now only need to complete the roleplay dungeon as Ayame. However, you can no longer get the Sengoku treasure set from this questline alone. Instead, you'll need to complete the Will of the Five Planets questline as well to unlock a boss battle with Princess No. This boss now drops the Sengoku treasure set items instead. At one point in this questline, you will need to talk to Hayato, but it seems he's receiving a bit too many visitors and is too tired to give us the energy needed to complete this questline. Until this has been fixed, it is not possible to face Princess No unless you already completed this quest before the update. So stay tuned, Maplus, for that emergency maintenance. The monsters and quests around Showa have been revamped as well. The monsters are now more in line with other monsters around the Maple World, which means that some Maplers will need to look for a new grinding spot between level 160 and 180, because the EXP those monsters in Showa used to give was ridiculously overpowered. Now it's actually normal. There have been plenty of smaller changes as well. You'll now find that Doran will sell ginger ales in his shop. Doran can be found in the Showa Street Market at the left. In the bathhouse, you can now also buy banana milk and melon milk. Banana milk transports you to Six Pet Crossway, and melon milk transports you to Leafra when used. These drinks can be used anywhere in the Maple World, so no longer you need to complete Gold Beach anymore for that guide UI teleport. You can just use these potions. By the way, if you find today's video useful, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more Maple Story content. Make sure to hit that bell notification as well, so you never miss an upload. The red slimes in the bathhouse have disappeared as well. In their place now are silver slimes. This map isn't too special, but I like the way it looks. To fight the boss in this area, first start with the Welcome to Showa quest from the light bulb on the left side of your screen. Then complete the quest from Sakura and add Crying Cat. For this quest you will need a total of 300 fried chicken. Who eats 300 fried chicken? Come on, Exxon! I actually just got those from the 24-hour store in the Ant Tunnel. It's a pretty easy way to get them. After you've done that part, complete the quiz by talking to the boss cat and selecting the option to take the quiz. The answers are a bottom, top. There you go, spoiled it for you. After you're done with that, complete the creature research quest from that old man who's at the left of the Showa market. Those boogies he's looking for can be found around the Mushroom Shrine. After that is done, you have to go back to the main street and complete the Popo Pass secret assignment and Fire Raccoon finance missions. By the way, when hunting monsters needed for this quest, I noticed that the monsters around here do drop some cool things like newspaper hats and metal bats. It's a great hunting spot for Maplers who are looking to collect items. Your next step in this questline is to find a comb from the female boss who is located in the hideout. You can talk to the NPC at the right of the main street to enter the hideout. It's actually quite funny, you also get a 6 car from completing the Popo Pass quest, only to be ridiculed by this dude over here right away. He's like, lose the fake scar, man, you look ridiculous. Like, whoa, I just worked really hard for this dude, please, let me have this. When fighting this boss, like previously, Maplers have to defeat two bodyguards before they're able to face off against the boss himself. The boss has new attack patterns, so I do recommend one-shotting him so you don't have to deal with those. The boss now also drops a Terminus Shield, Hawabi Throwing Stars, an Intense Power Crystal, and Showa Town and Fire Raccoon Damage Skin, so it's definitely worth the visit. Showa has plenty more secrets to uncover, like feeding this cat with certain items will increase your traits. After completing a certain questline, you can purchase special Showa equipment, you can ride a trolley, like there's so much stuff to do here. I would recommend completing most quests here as they always unlock something. After completing the quests where you need to find a purse, a special weekly mission unlocks as well where you can obtain a Storm Growth Potion during the event period. So make sure to check that out as well if you're looking for some free level ups if you have the time. Ninja Castle has received a new interior as well, so no more nail-curling jump quest. Instead, Maplers are treated to a maze-like castle where quick wit and memory will help you figure out the layout. Each room you enter will give you a hint where the correct portal will be. Sometimes if you enter the wrong portal, you'll be sent to a punishment room where you just need to sit still and wait for a minute before you can leave again. The second stage of this maze is even more crazy though. Each room has three doors. One sends you forward, one sends you backwards, and one sends you all the way back to the beginning. I wrote down the door for every room I took just to make it easier for myself to memorize which door I needed to take every room, and after that it became quite easy. It is important to be quick though. If you finish the whole maze within 10 minutes, the final boss will transform into his final form with even better drops. If you're too slow, the boss will only transform into his second form and you'll get a bit less drops. After we complete the maze, we can finally face the boss, this dude that transforms into a toad. and later into his frenzied mode if you finish the maze within 10 minutes. This boss has a chance to drop Terminus weapons as well as a 30-day pet, which could be useful for everyone looking for a free pet in both the reboot and regular server. He also drops a golden toad, and this toad can be exchanged for special gear, a damage skin and a fusion anvil for the price of a couple of these toads. Another minor change happened as well this update. To make the Mushroom Shrine Threats of Fate more doable, the closeness of NPCs will now be reduced weekly. The gifts also has been changed from daily gifts to weekly gifts. You can give a couple of those a week. Now onwards to the events. The Haste Plus event is back. During this event, elite monsters and runes will appear more frequent. The rune cooldown has been decreased as well for even more EXP buffs. Maplus can now also complete twice as many surprise missions. Defeating the Infernal Wolf gives more EXP, and boss party buffs are enhanced. When accepting the event, each day Maplus can complete up to 6 missions. Hunt 999 monsters, hunt 15 elite monsters, defeat the Infernal Wolf, activate 5 runes and clear 1 surprise mission. Each time you complete a mission, you can open a box containing various goodies like double EXP cards, event ring cubes, arcane symbol selectors and many other useful items. Once you complete all 6 daily missions, a hidden weekly mission appears where you have to hunt 100k monsters. This box rewards a special title, a special mount and damage skin. However, I did hear some Maplers say that this box is bugged at the moment. So about that emergency maintenance. And finally, the Legend Returns PvP event is active as well. Face off against other Maplers in this team battle event. You transform yourself into an avatar with unique skills, defeat monsters to level up and collect gold, upgrade your stats with the gold you earn and try to defeat as many of the other Maplers as possible. The top 100 ranked Maplers will receive up to 50k Maple points when the event ends, as well as special titles that increase EXP. If you're part of the last 7,000 Maplers on the ranking, you'll still receive a special title that grants 10% bonus EXP, so especially in less crowded servers, it is quite easy to reach that, so totally go for that. There are even more exciting events coming soon to the Maple world, so there's never a dull moment. Make sure to take advantage of the events and the revamped content. I wish everyone a happy Mapling and I hope everyone enjoys the update. And maybe see you in the game or catch you in one of our streams. And that was all for today. As always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Comic, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Jeff Wong, Pinky Traveler, Terry Kim, Jiju, Galaxy Art, Jesus Rodriguez, Varese, Riser Ayu, Dries Sumker, Plux, Zenny, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace OTI, CMAC, Safronix, Alonso BG Extremes, Harry Gardner, Ido Hyman, Anwar NHI, Brandon, Frank Bouguette, Ziggy Deer, Fine Asian Guy, Mr. Potemkin, Flidiot, and Beamer WT. If you'd like to be mentioned you as well and get early access to new videos, make sure to check out that join button below this video. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and happy Mapling!